Difficulty in video games is a tricky thing. I love the feeling of triumph when I beat a game, but that pride is often undermined by the fact that many games are artificially hard. The original Ghosts and Goblins was notorious for being difficult thanks to a lack of checkpoints, abundance of enemies, and other random gimmicks. I'm happy to report that Ghosts and Goblins Resurrection is a genuinely challenging game. While a large amount of the difficulty can be attributed to the abundance of bad guys, there is a hint of tricky platforming and a variety of attack patterns throughout all the enemies that makes the difficulty feel organic. On top of that, the storybook art style allows enemies and projectiles to pop out more while also looking visually pleasing. There are some things that don't pan out in conjunction with the art style, however. Some obstacles will do damage to you when it looks like you aren't close to them, and sometimes enemy droppings will blend in with the environment. Another misstep is the clunky movement. I don't mind the lack of a double jump since everything else is scaled down to make one jump more than enough in any scenario. However, you can barely move in the air to strategically avoid attacks. Your character is also extremely unagile and awkward to move uphill. Even despite all of my critiques of the movement, my enjoyment of this game comes from how consistent it is. It masterfully balances platforming and combat to keep things fresh. Killing enemies always remains satisfying due to some visual flair, and the difficulty evolves at a smooth pace. One other thing to note is the skill tree, which doesn't add as much as it sounds like it would. Most skills need to be charged up, which leaves you vulnerable to getting attacked. That said, it works on rare occasions and the skill tree doesn't take anything away from the experience. Even though the movement is incredibly clunky and there are some gimmicks here that don't pan out, Resurrection is a great way to bring back a classic and adjust it to modern standards. I just hope Capcom continues to build on this foundation in the future. 7 out of 10.